Today I'd like to provide an informational video that will give information, describe the different types of qualities and grades of sea glass that can be found here in the Puget Sound area if a person is looking for collecting beach glass or trying to look at different beaches that might have beach glass on them. There's a wide variety of quality and a wide variety of the grading that can be found in the different types of beach glass that are here. One particular area that I've looked in on the Kitsap Peninsula in the Puget Sound area is in the beaches that are more in the inner harbor areas that are very accessible to a lot of beachcombers. One particular area is called the Harper Beach area, is on the eastern side of the Kitsap Peninsula. It's a really old community that's been around for over 100 years and has had established businesses there. And on the waterfront area down by the beach, you can find lots of different types of sea glass. The kinds of sea glass that I have found on several different trips down there is basically the kind of craft grade sea glass of the whites and the browns and greens and some aquas and even some cobalt blues. But the beach glass there is of the lower quality, but it's really beautiful in many ways. It can be used for craft projects and for various types of projects you have in craft making. And so it's really not the jewelry quality beach glass that you'll find in other areas that I'll show in a later part of this video, but is a diverse type of beach, and it's quite thick beach glass, that is thick and is quite old in its own being there on deposited on the beach. And so I'd like to zoom in on some of these pieces and some of the various fragments I've found were very old pieces of sea glass, from old bottles that had different types of embossed shapes on them, different kinds of even toning colors. There's some purple glass, maybe have just been shaded and turned purple because of the exposure to the sunlight and being on the beach. There's even some beach glass that I've found in the local areas that is formed by what they call bonfire beach glass. It's been thrown into a fire by various people in the past, and it's melted down into a glob of beach glass. And you'll find several pieces of this on other beaches that have more of a surf, intense surf, like up in the Port Townsend area in Port Angeles. But the beach glass that I have found has on the Harper Beach on the east part of Kitsap Peninsula is really has some frosting on it, some weatherization from the action of the ocean, but the actual sea, the pummeling of the waves is a far less than actually out there on the Port Townsend area. So we'll see various tones and various qualities of colors. There's sort of an amber. Lots of the browns of the different kinds of bottles you'll find, but the amber is not too readily found out there. A little bit of actual bottles that came from jars, that is, food jars, mason jars, some pottery. Interesting, though, in the inner harbor parts of the beach, like Harper Beach and other areas on the Kitsap Peninsula, the wave action is so reduced that the actual impact upon the glass is kind of a weathering or a yellowing because of the exposure to maybe to more water that's not as not moving with the surf. And so you do have different colors, different shapes that have been shaped and weathered. And the frosting is on most of the sea glass. Some of it has far less frosting than what you'd find on the more heavily surfed beaches that have high surf, like in Port Townsend and Port Angeles. But still, the weatherization is clear that over a period of time, this glass has been exposed to the elements on the beach in the water, and specifically the seawater with all the salt content has still created the actual effect of frosting and a little bit of pitting. And over a period of time, it would be greater if left in the surf. So the variety is amazing out there, but the pieces are a lot larger than you'd find out there on the surf on Port Townsend or on Glass Beach in that area because of the lack of surf action, the lack of tumbling that's going on the beach. And so in later part of this video, we'll expose you to some higher grade sea glass that's found on other beaches. This particular collection right here in this jar is from Damon Point in the Ocean Shores area. And then the rest of these bottles were removed from the Glass Beach area out beyond McCurdy Point in the Port Townsend area with various colors and various types. And we'll explore what those are and the different kinds of qualities that can be found and the actual frosting that's found on sea glass that's found on those type of beaches. But sea glass is everywhere. You can find it in almost every beach that you explore in the Pacific Northwest. It's everywhere, can be found at different qualities. And with the different qualities, if it's gonna be found in mostly like this type right here on Harper Beach, is the craft quality. It's still, you can use it in different various types of craft projects and even jewelry if you wanted to make some jewelry out of it. But it's very prevalent, can be found everywhere. So enjoy your hunting out there in some of these inner harbor beaches. There's plenty of glass, plenty of beautiful objects to be found. Well, the value of sea glass is really determined by the collector's need for it and use of it and how they can use it in crafting. But typically the actual sea glass that is collected by the collector on the beach is determined its usefulness by what it looks like. Maybe it has some type of special ancient embossing on it from older styles glass or different types of mason jars in the past, or maybe it's based upon its usefulness in the crafting project if it's a flatter type piece of glass, or it has a different types of coloration on it. But whether it's yellows or it's some kind of auburn, amber, or the browns or the greens, it's all very useful in the crafter. But when you look at craft grade sea glass is actually graded in two different grades. It's craft grade A and craft grade B. Craft grade A is typically the thoroughly frosted piece of sea glass, but it has lots of jagged edges all around it. But the level of frosting is really what determines the level of grade for craft grade sea glass. And so various types of craft grade, depending on the type of usefulness it is for the crafter, will determine what kind of grade it is. If it is frosted all the way around, but it has very, very interesting markings or embossings because it used to be part of a bottle or whatever, may provide a higher level of value to the crafter. Different types of sea glass at the craft grade are found on the beach like this. Most of this was found at Harper Beach, more of the inner part of the Puget Sound, where the sea and the actual surf was far less. And so the level of actually tumbling and of the level of frosting is far less than the type of sea glass that's found out on maybe the Port Townsend area on Glass Beach, where you have different types of cornflower blue or cobalt blue, but the thorough complete rounding of all the edges and the frosting and the pitting of the outer surface of the glass is really what determines what they call jewelry grade sea glass. And so jewelry grade sea glass is a thoroughly frosted, thoroughly rounded, thicker piece of glass that can be used for jewelry purposes. But it's the level of frosting that is actually has occurred in the pitting on the actual surface of the glass that determines whether it's jewelry grade A or possibly a jewelry grade B. Jewelry grade B will be thoroughly frosted, thoroughly rounded, but it may still have a small edge of it that is chipped. And so this particular piece that is thoroughly frosted, thoroughly rounded, but with a small one chipped area, could still be used for jewelry grade different types of crafting, making jewelry or whatever, but it's called jewelry grade B because of the chipping that's on the outer edge of it. And so yeah, this is the more abundant color is the clear or white sea glass, which is found out on Glass Beach. And then you have the more rare different colors of the aquas, the very, very light blue, the light greens, and the aqua colors. The more rare pieces, you find would be like the yellows that have been found. These are very small pieces of yellow sea glass found out in Glass Beach, or even pinks. The really extreme rare, possibly the orange, a light color orange there, or even red. The red is extremely rare and very, very difficult to find. Over on the Damon Point Beach on Ocean Shores, there's plenty of different illustrations you can find of maybe probably jewelry grade B that is thoroughly rounded, thoroughly frosted, but still with quite a few jagged edges. It's really difficult to find the jewelry grade A. All of these pieces came off of that Damon Point Beach. This is pretty close to being a jewelry grade A. Most of the pieces found out there, though, would be maybe determined to be the jewelry grade B or even craft, because this particular piece is fairly large, but it has lots of different blemishes and chips in it. But it's also kind of a strange shaped piece, and so depending on the shape of the piece will determine its value for the crafter who might be able to do something with it. Like these craft grade pieces off of Harper Beach that have really interesting shapes might make it difficult for a crafter to turn it into a piece of jewelry, but if they like what it looks like and they're able to do something with it, or it has lots of different etchings or embossings from older style bottles of Pepsi or Cola, they might be useful for the crafter. So white and the browns, the dark browns, are really the more prevalent pieces of what you do find, especially out on Glass Beach in Port Townsend, that are thoroughly frosted, they have the pitting all over them, and they're really good for jewelry grade type of craft projects. One of the last kinds of interesting glass you can find over, especially out there on Glass Beach in Port Townsend, and in a few other places, is what I called earlier part of the video, is called the bonfire glass, or glass that's been basically heated up inside of a fire on the beach. And so you might have a two-tone type of glass. You have here like a clear and a green. So because of the heating process that goes on the beach, glass might be bonded together with two different colors. And so you have also a bubbling effect that happens while it's in the fire. So you have a lot of this glass beach that's been in a bonfire has a kind of a pitting or a bubbling effect that goes on as it's going through the heating process. And so not only do you have two-tone type of glass, but you also have these bubbling effect. And sometimes you might even find a piece of sea glass that's been in a bonfire or a fire on the beach, but also may have a bubble on the inside of it. And you might have the movement of air or movement of water going back and forth, almost like on a level. And so that's really an obscure piece you can find and really valuable for some of the collectors. And so finding this type of bonfire or glass on the beach is fun to do. And sometimes, if you can, what I have not found yet are actual marbles off the beach. And so all of them have different levels of two-tone. They have been mixed with different colors of glass because of the fire effect. One particular piece I found a few months ago walking on North Beach up in Port Townsend was an actual florist-type frog piece, which is used for floral arrangements. And so I found this in a pile of a bunch of gravel and large rocks and looked down, it was just glowing up, and thought, my goodness, there it is. And so really obscure type of piece of glass, but it's used in floral arrangements. But there, who knows how long it had been on the beach tumbling and having its edges roughed up, but a fairly large piece. And so for the collector who's looking for glass and sea glass, whatever beach you're on, if it's the more beach that has the higher level of wave action and surf going on, you will find a higher level of frosting and pitting, and the level of jewelry grade will be more susceptible to find in those type of beaches and in the gravel bars. So that's where I like to go. And as I go out more and more and looking for more and more pieces, the collector really loves to look for the different obscure, more rare colors, especially the pinks and the yellows and oranges and reds, and especially the cobalt blue is not as rare, but it is fairly rare. And the pieces that I have found are fairly small, and so hopefully I'll find some larger pieces in the coming few months as I go out there. So looking for glass is an amazing, enjoyable experience, but there's all different types of grades, different types of values, different types of rarities that the different collectors can use, depending on the kinds of crafts they want to use it for, or it's jewelry. And so you can really have a great time looking for different qualities and different styles of sea glass. And so enjoy. So if you'd like to know more about collecting sea glass and where to find it and how to grade it and to understand the different types of qualities, there's lots of information on my website, which is at PNW for Pacific Northwest, PNWBeachcombing.com. And you can find lots of information about how to grade and different graphics about the different qualities and types of sea glass that can be found on different beaches. There's also, or found on the website, many different field reports about different actual beaches you can go to find different types of rocks and agates and sea glass and different beaches in the Puget Sound area on the Olympic Peninsula and also out on the Pacific Coast on the southwest part of Washington State. So I hope you can find lots of sea glass. I hope you have a good time looking for it. It's a great hobby, great pastime. Have a great day.